What's up, guys? The K-U-A-D-A. Coot. Nah, that's not it. That's not it. Hi, guys. Right? Nah, that's not it. I ain't spinner. No, that's not it. That's damn it. That's not it. What's up, guys? WWEKILO504. That's what's up. That's it. So, anyways, came up with. I've been getting video ideas from my subscribers. So, one of my video ideas was do the 10 most markout moments ever. Markout is when you go fucking nuts. 10 most markout moments. So, you guys ready? Is top 10 in wrestling ever. Number 10 to me is when Chris Jericho came to Raw, because it wasn't that long between his contract ending and him coming to Raw. I think he was actually still advertised coming to Raw when he was still on SmackDown. So that was crazy right there. So that was stupid. Number 9 most marked out moments in wrestling. When Hulk Hogan beat Kevin Nash, when Hulk Hogan beat Kevin Nash for that goddamn title, that was crazy. If you don't know, in the match, Hulk Hogan and Kevin Nash are fighting off 1-on-1 for the title, and Hulk Hogan touches him, like, with a finger, he says, boop, and Kevin Nash says, boop, and falls back, like that, and, it was funny, it was stupid, it was crazy. That was stupid. Number 8 has to be, number 8 is one of my favorites, has to be, the most markout moment is probably some old, and people, I'm probably going to get knocked for this too, but I don't give a fuck, it's my list. If I get to get anything you think that should be on this list, then leave a comment or something, you know, I'll see what's up. But anyways, number 8 markout moment has to be when Steen joins the NWO. That is, you gotta understand, at that time, Sting was like the only babyface that WCW had, other than Hulk Hogan, but Hollywood Hogan had already joined the NWO, so Sting joined the NWO is kind of like another, that second knife in WCW's back, even though they probably wish that they had some shit like that happen before they died, right? Number seven most markout moment is not a good markout moment either. Markout moments can be good and they can be bad. This number seven markout moment is David Arquette winning the title. David Arquette winning the fucking title. Like, come the fuck on. Like, really? That's bullshit. Really, him winning the fucking title. I mean, he's an actor. He's not even like a big guy. He's not even like a tough guy actor. He's an actor, you know. But, it was, people got pissed off. That what made people stop watching WCW right there. They started coming out with these stupid ass gimmicks. They had three cages on top of each other and shit. That was stupid. Number 6 most markout moment has to be Vince Russo. Just Vince Russo. Every time people see Vince Russo, they get pissed off. They get mad. They get angry. Or whatever, so it's not even fucking cool. Number 5 most markout moments. We're getting top 5 right now. Top 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So stay with me, okay? Number 5 most markout moments is Jeff Hardy hitting the Swanton Bomb at WrestleMania 2000 off of the fucking ladder onto the table, onto the Bully Ray. On the Bully Ray of 3D, you know. So that was the Dudley Brothers. So that was fucking cool right there. That whole match was actually a whole markout moment. That whole TLC match on WrestleMania 2000, I still look at it today, and it's still a fucking markout moment. That whole match, really. Number 4 markout moment happened this year. It's two markout moments that happened this year is in the top 5, so I guess WWE's doing good. Number 4 is when The Rock came back this year. Of course, they'll come host WrestleMania. People went wild. I went wild too, you know, until I realized what he was doing or whatever. But people went wild. Everybody went wild, you know, because The Rock is was blowing and he came back, you know. But of course he always leaves, so you never fucking know. Number three is Goldberg winning the title from Hollywood Hogan. Goldberg winning the title from Hollywood Hogan back in 1999 or 2000. That was crazy right there, because Hollywood Hogan was running the fucking game. He was running WCW. He was the ultimate evil guy. Goldberg was the ultimate Superman at that time. He was unstoppable. He was the guy that everybody wanted to go against NWO. And plus, the weeks leading up to that match was so fucking hyped up. It was so... Goldberg got locked up. The NWO got Goldberg locked up and shit. Scott Hall hitting Goldberg with a taser. Goldberg actually breaking his hand on a glass window and shit like that. But in Atlanta, when Goldberg won that title, that was crazy. That was real fucking crazy when Goldberg won that title. So, congrats to him. Number two markout moments as so far happened this year. Just happened like, let's see. Happened actually a week ago. CM Punk winning the WWE title is a fucking markout moment. My fellow YWC mates had a fucking orgasm when he won the title. So, you know, I didn't really care. I marked out too, not in a good way. I got pissed off, but when I sat down, I realized I slept on it, and I woke up. I was like, hey, you know, WWE is doing great things right now, so you know, it's crazy. And that was one of the most marked out moments of this. Number one, of course, is Hulk Hogan turning into Hollywood Hogan at the Bash at the Beach with the Outsiders. If you don't know what that is, you need to go see that, and you need to go see how people react to that. You need to go see the reaction of that night. You need to go see the reaction of the weeks after that. Yeah, I mean, it's crazy. It's mark out. It's a big ass mark out moment. I think people forget about that moment. When Hulk Hogan was a good guy, basically. Hulk Hogan, basically, this is why people saying that John Cena turning heel might work, because Hulk Hogan was basically in the same place that John Cena was, and people was booing Hulk Hogan too, just like they're booing John Cena. So you never fucking know. But he turned to the NWO. He went with Scott Hall and Kevin Nash. Everybody remembers. I don't think everybody remembers, but I'm gonna explain to you. It was a 3-on-3 match. Outsiders had a mystery partner. It was Sting, Lex Luger, and Macho Man Randy Savage. So the good guy team, which was Macho, Sting, and Luger, was losing, and Hogan was coming out, and people actually thought Hulk Hogan was on the side of the good guys, which would have been 4-on-2, which wouldn't make no damn sense. So Hulk Hogan came out there and hit a leg drop on Macho Man, which was crazy. So that was pretty fucking cool right there when he hit that leg drop. And everybody was like, what? Everybody marked out. Actually, a fan tried to jump in. It was so fucking crazy. So those are my top 10 markout moments in my opinion. Don't knock me, because it's my fucking opinion, boy. Don't fucking knock me. It's my fucking opinion, boy. I'll fuck your ass up. And I'm not putting no fucking links. But, just leave a comment, like this video, subscribe, right there, and shit, I'll hit y'all up later, you know what I'm saying? Just had to make that video real quick for my subscribers. Peace out.